So I'm riding two bikes at once. This is a Cannondale Supersix, and it's an Evo. Well, you already know that, don't you? You've seen it on the title. It's a 56 centimeter. I'm 183. Personal preference. It's a beautiful looking bike. It is really, wow, it's got a little ridge there.
That's interesting. Oh, wow, look at that. See that?
Oh, this feels, it's very light for the money. So this comes stock with a full 105 5800 group set, which is probably my favourite group set. I like this as good as Durace. The 5800 group set is incredible. These brakes. Now, Cannondale, thumbs up from doing right for putting 105 brakes in there. They could have saved money, but these brakes are so good. They're fucking really, really good. Seat post 25.4. So I'll give it a flex. The saddle. It's a nice straight shape, but I like this saddle's personal preference. There's no right or wrong saddle. It's just whatever works for you when it comes to that. So 25.4, a bit of flex, bit of comfort there. And got 28 in the back. I prefer a 32 or bigger, but that's it. That's personal preference, not a bad thing. Depends where you live. We've got a, this spider's easy to take off, relatively easy. We can put a compact on there. This is a 52-36. You know me, I like the 50-34 or smaller, because all I do is pretty much ride mountains. But it is beautiful bike, very finished really well. And the tire clearance, I do like the tire clearance. Yeah, the twigs on there. This is real time reviews. You know me, I do real time reviews. Nothing photoshopped here. That's a pretty good clearance. We'll see what we can run in there. The Axiom rims, the Mavic. I've used these, they're not bad. The tires are fine. It's a good wheel set. It's a good wheel set. I'm gonna put my wheel set in there, my tires, just so I can feel what this frame gives me. And I'm gonna put my saddle on there. I'm gonna put a power meter on there. It's a 172.5 crank, so I'll put a power tap on there, because I'll put a power tap on the back. And just so I can put watts through the bike, see how it handles, see how it feels under wattage. We've got the new BB30A bottom brackets, a 73mm instead of 68. A little bit, I mean, it looks cool. If anything, it looks cool, but it adds a little bit extra stiffness. But if you, unless you're banging out 2000 watts, you may not notice. But it looks good, and it's just gonna be good. I've been riding Cannondale bikes since 1998 when I first got my barbecue black F4000 full XTR back in the day. And I've got an Evo myself, I've got a Cannondale Criterium, I've got a Cad 9, which I've had for 9 years. So, bike with Bicycle Express loan, this bike's not sponsored, Mons Imports will sponsor me. It's just a bike, so do it, jump on it, see what you think, if you like it, blah, 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 give us a bit of feedback. And this is what we're doing. So we're gonna bring it out this week, we're gonna give it a bit of thrashing, a little bit of nice thrashing, and see how we go. You got any questions about the Evo? Tilt the helmet and leave a comment down below, and we'll see you on the road. So things I love straight away, the frame, the tire clearance, the bit of flex in the seat post, the 105 group set, the 105 brakes, I love that. The wheel set, it works. It works, the tires work. The only thing I don't like is doing on a spec. I love small chainrings. I love to spin, high cadence, Chris Froome, Lance Armstrong, Dr. Ferrari style riding. Put 32 in the back. This is a climbing bike. This is a fucking beast. So that's the pros and cons. There's no real pros and cons, because you can change that really easy. Point of purchase even. This looks pretty rad as well. This is interesting. It's like it's in the hangar. Interesting stuff. But that B screw, that's ready for 32, isn't it? That's ready for 32. So we can see here, this is the Cad 9. We've got the Cad 9 going on. Clearance is, you know, old school, 2007. I've got this bike, November 2007. Fast forward 9 years later, November 2016. I'm back at Bicycle Express, and we have, 9 years later, the Evolution, the Evo. It's a lot of clearance in there. It's got a lot of clearance here, but not much side clearance. We can see here, we can put fatter tyres in there, so it's a bit more compliant. Still great bike, the old Cad 9. They make good stuff. Look at that BB-ness. You can sort of see the alloy in there. This is a big chunk. We call it the beat box. But, so it's a Taiwanese-made carbon frame. They make good stuff. This is US-made. Again, make good stuff, but it does look pretty cool. I do like the detail underneath the bike. It's quite pretty underneath this little belly. External cables, a little bit easier to manage, potentially. The old external ones down here. And then we can see the forks. This is a Columbus Tusk fork. But it does look... I do like that fluor colour. Actually, I would like this colour on the whole bike, really. Personal preferences. Let's not let our personal bias affect the review now, during order. The hubs roll pretty good. Spin them. But Durace... The Durace hub set, with the Mavics, it's good enough. It's very good. I mean, it's sort of, if I had to close my eyes, I couldn't tell which is which, you know, which is which. If you want to have compliance, run fatter tires, 25mm. These do look like we're going to run 28s. We'll have to suss it out.